In this video, I'm giving you the answers for the task 3, where I asked you to find out what are the subsections that you will have in your introduction section. All right, so I evaluated 5 SLR papers in my discipline, in my field, and I have concluded that the introduction section should have 8 subsections. All right, so what are these 8 subsections? So firstly, you can begin the introduction with the background of your topic or your area of your research. So that is the first thing. The second thing is if you can add some form of an evolution, like this is how your industry or how your research has evolved, something that happened in say year 2000 and 2005, 2010, and we are 2022 now. So how has the research or the field evolved? So if you can, if it relates to your area, then you can add something along the evolution. The next thing that you can talk about is the motivation. Yeah, why are you doing this research? Why were you motivated to conduct this research? So motivation is the third subsection that you can have. This you can follow with the significance of the research. So you are motivated to do it, but then you also list the significance. Why is this research important? Why am I spending my time doing this research? So that is significance. You can also add a section on relevance. Why should I do this SLR at this point of time? You know, what is the relevance of this research? So you're kind of creating the background to justify the research that you're doing. Okay, so once that is done, you can then list your research questions. Okay, the research question as a heading, because later down the track in the future tasks, I will be teaching you how you can create systematic research questions for your systematic literature review paper. But for now, in the introduction section, make a section about make a subsection for research questions. Once that is done, we move on to the another section which I call contributions of this study. So here you highlight clearly 5, 6 or whatever number of contributions that you are going to make by doing this SLR. And how we will do that will be in the future sessions again. And finally, you can then add a structure or a layout of your paper. Either here you can say the section 2 will be about literature review, section 3 will be about methodology, and so on. Or you can be even more creative, like I do in some of my papers, is you draw a figure, say section 1, section 2, section 3, and so on. And underneath each section, you can have a subsection. So it gives a clear idea for the reader to follow your research paper. And the reason for doing this is because systematic literature review papers can be quite long. So if you have provide a proper structure to the reader at the beginning, it will help them to read your paper in a more effective way. Okay, so that is the answer for this task. I hope you also have got something similar along here. If not, if you have got some other sections that you have decided or you have identified and you want to include in your introduction, please do so and do leave them in the comments. So even I can improve and anyone else, everyone else who is following this task of the day series can learn from you as well. All right. Thank you very much. And have a good rest of the evening. And I'll come back again next tomorrow with the next task. Thank you very much. Bye.